Hey guys, it's Jeff. I'm here with Evan. Evan, what are we doing today?
Today we're out here at Cane Bay to take some pictures and measurements of one of the anchors out here to make a cool 3D model.
So today we're going to get under the water and we're gonna show you how to make this happen. So it's really cool. We got to take a lot of pictures and we got to take a lot of measurements, and we're going to stitch together this model afterwards. So stick with us through the end of the video, and if you like what you see, make sure to subscribe. All right, let's go diving. So Cane Bay out here on the north shore of St. Croix has dozens and dozens of anchors. They all date back to the 17th to 19th centuries, and they're really historical artifacts. Today we're gonna go find one that's in the shallow water. It's about 20 feet deep. It's one that's probably rarely visited. Not many divers go over there. It's a little bit to the east of the main dive site, out in front of a restaurant called Off the Wall. And so we're headed out there. We're gonna mark it with GPS. We've got one of those with us today in our orange float here. We've also got some measuring tape with us today. So we're gonna measure the different dimensions of the anchor. And then we're gonna take probably about 100, 200 photographs of it as well, all around and over the top of it, and stitch those back together once we're on shore into a 3D model using photogrammetry and some fancy software. All right, well, swimming across the surface of the anchor we're looking for, we came across another one here. This one's pretty well buried in the coral, but the ring and the shank are really exposed. So let's check that out real quick.
Okay, so just to give a quick tour of the anchor here, it looks like it dates back to the 17th to the 19th century. It's been down here for quite some time. It doesn't have a stock on it. The stock is the bar that kind of would be vertical here at the top where the ring is. It was probably wooden and it's rotted away long ago. It's got a pretty good sized ring to it. It's got a long arm down here. This is probably a bower anchor for a small ship, or maybe a secondary anchor for a larger one. But considering that we're 21 feet of water, this is probably a bow anchor for a small ship. The draft here is pretty shallow for anything larger. To create a 3D model, we have to take them very close together. There's about 70 to 80% overlap of the previous picture. Only this way can the software kind of stitch the images together so they can create that model using photogrammetry. We also have to go all the way around the object here. So we're just going to keep taking these images over and over again from every angle, from the sides to the top, really get that full model. We want to get every every inch of our anchor here so that that model comes out when we run it through the software.
So really successful dive today. We got all the pictures that we need. We took dozens of measurements as well of the anchor. So what we're going to do now is pack up and head back. And tonight we're going to run all those images through some software. And it's going to probably take 8 to 12 hours to, you know, stitch all those images together, create a model. But through the magic of video, we're just going to bring that straight to you. So let's check it out. All right, we are in our home office today, and overnight we processed all the images that we took. In total, it was about 198 images, and we ran it through some software called Metashape. It's by a company called Agisoft. We don't have any affiliation with them, but they make amazing software for doing photogrammetry. We've got a link to them in the description below, so totally check them out. But at any rate, let's take a look at what we did overnight. So the first thing we did is we loaded all those photos into the software package and ran it through the workflow. So we can take a look and see the photos here are all the little blue triangles with the images over them. It's every photo kind of aligned in its position in the water column from where we took it above or around the anchor. So it's extrapolated all those data into different points underneath. And so if we clear the images real quick, we can take a look at those points. Okay, so hiding the images gets us these points, and we can see that the anchor is actually starting to take shape a little bit here. So the next thing we need to do is kind of tie all those points together into a wire mesh. So we're going to create that. Okay, so we've got our wire mesh here, and we can really see the shape of our anchor starting to come together with the big long shank here and our ring on the end, as well as these big arms that were there with the palms. If we rotate this around, we can really see that there's a lot of detail in there as well. So the next step is to then overlay this with all the image data for colors and textures. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so we've got all of our colors and textures here, and I'm just gonna move the object up real quick, our anchor here, so, and rotate it around so we can get a better look at the whole thing here. So we can now really see that it looks exactly like the anchor that we saw yesterday and we're diving on. So if we just kind of rotate this all the way around, we can see every aspect of it. So really a great documentation tool. Love it, absolutely love it. So you may be wondering what we're gonna do with all this data. Obviously yesterday we spent a lot of time diving, measuring, taking lots of photographs, lots of video. We created our model here. We've also got the GPS coordinates. So we've really got everything we need to know about this anchor and its location. And so we wanna share that and make it public. So we're doing two things. One is we're gonna send it off as a big package to the U.S. Virgin Islands State Historic Preservation Office, and hopefully they'll include it in their inventory there. And then second, there's a project called the Big Anchor Project. You can check their website out at biganchorproject.com. But that's a project done by the Nautical Archaeology Society in the United Kingdom. And they have a big database online of different anchors around the world. So it's a global project. On their website, you can see different ways on how to document and map anchors. They've got a lot of information out there, great resource. So we're going to contribute our data to their project as well, so it can be shared out there. So check that out. So we're always learning. So you know, if you guys have any comments, suggestions, tips, put them in the comments below on photogrammetry or the anchors or documenting or sharing the data or really anything. We'd love to hear from you. And if you're not yet a subscriber, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Hit the little bell notification next to it. That way you'll never miss a dive. And we try to spend a lot of time in the water and bring it to you. So we want to share it all. But until next time, stay safe and keep diving.